Okay, children. So we'll do some important questions in metals and non-metals, just like revision. We'll do some important questions in metals and non-metals. Tell me the questions. Answer, children. First question. List five properties of metals and compare them with non-metals. Any five properties difference
metals
between
metals are hard. They are sonorous.
Ductile.
They're malleable.
They're
ductile.
They're ductile. They have high melting point. They have high boiling point.
Sonorous.
They conduct electricity.
Lustrous.
High melting point. High boiling point.
High MP and BP.
Conduct electricity.
Yeah, good conductors of heat and electricity. Some. Okay. Some differences between metals and non-metals. I want this. Some only. So they are malleable, ductile. And non-metals are non-malleable, non-ductile, non-sonorous, non-lustrous, low MP and low BP, and bad conductors of heat and electricity.
Yes, sir.
Second question. Why is gold widely used for making jewelry? Why is gold widely used in making jewelry?
It is highly malleable, ductile.
Basically,
lustrous.
It is least reactive. Number one, it's least reactive. Number two, do not corrode. They do not corrode, children. Gold do not corrode or do not rust. Okay, rusting they have to say for iron. Gold do not corrode. And it is also lustrous. It is also lustrous. And it is malleable and ductile. Malleable and ductile. Best reason is do not corrode and least reactive, children, actually. Malleable and ductile, even copper is there, iron is there. Okay, and of course lustrous also. So mainly it is least reactive. If you put on our body also, they don't react with our body. Any harm that doesn't cause. In fact, it is good for health also. Next, name one metal commonly used for making cooking utensils. Give reason. For cooking utensils, which is best instrument? Name one metal which is commonly used for making cooking utensils.
Copper, aluminium, steel.
Copper is best, children. Actually, copper is best. But normally, we use steel. What is steel? Steel is what, children? Iron plus carbon. Steel.
Iron plus carbon is an alloy.
Yeah, steel is iron plus carbon. But more than steel, copper is better. Why copper is better than steel means it is the best conductor of heat and electricity. Of course, after silver only, but silver is very costly, no, children. So it is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Good conductor of heat and electricity. And also, children, basically, copper is less reactive. Copper is less reactive. Copper is less reactive. If you see reactivity series, it is present below hydrogen. Because it is present below hydrogen, it do not liberate hydrogen. Because it is present below hydrogen, it do not liberate hydrogen when reacted with water. Even when reacted with water, it won't react because it is less reactive than hydrogen. Normally, children, metals, when they react with water, they liberate hydrogen gas. But copper won't liberate. Why? Because it is present below hydrogen. These are the reasons. You have to remember, children, in 10th class also, all these are very, very important. In 10th class also, they are asking. Next. All metals exist at solid at room temperature. Give an example. Give one liquid metal. Give an example of liquid metal.
Mercury.
Mercury. Give an example of liquid metal means mercury. Next one example. Non-metals which are lustrous. Non-metals which are lustrous.
Iodine.
Non-metals which is lustrous is iodine. Non-metal which is lustrous is iodine. Normally they are non-lustrous, but non-metal which is lustrous is iodine. Okay, next question. Non-metals which conduct electricity. A non-metal which is good conductor.
Graphite.
Yes, graphite is good conductor of heat and electricity. That's why it is used as electrode. What are the electrodes we have seen? Cathode and anode. What is an anode which is connected to positive
connect
terminal?
Connect to positive terminal.
And negative terminal. Metals are generally hard. Can you name any two soft metals which can cut with knife also?
Sir, aluminium.
Sodium and potassium are soft like a cake. We can cut with knife also. Sodium and potassium are soft. You can cut with knife also. They are generally hard. Sodium and potassium are so soft that you can cut with knife. Generally, solid non-metals are brittle. Name some strongest non-metal.
Diamond. Sir, diamond.
Diamond. Graphite is brittle. Na? Diamond is the best example, which is very, very, very hard. In fact, hardest on the earth. And ironically, it is non-metal. It is a non-metal. Next question. Yeah. So, Next question. What is observed when magnesium ribbon is burnt? Children, what happens when magnesium ribbon is burnt? Okay, children, fifth question actually is, what happens when magnesium ribbon is burnt and copper is burnt in air? When magnesium is burnt in air, what do you get, children?
It releases
magnesium oxide. When copper is burnt in air, you'll get copper oxide. Please check, children. Two. Children, when magnesium is burnt in air, you'll get white dazzling light. When magnesium is burnt in air, you'll get white dazzling light. When magnesium is burnt in air, you'll get a white dazzling. When copper is reacting with oxygen, you'll get black copper oxide. All of you should remember these answers. When copper is reacted with the oxygen, you'll get black copper oxide. Copper with oxygen gives black copper oxide. Copper with oxygen gives black copper oxide. Don't forget, children, 2 to CuO. Okay, next. Name 2 metal oxides that are soluble in water. Normally, metals are not soluble in water, no? Name 2 metal oxides which are soluble in water. Sodium oxide, potassium oxide, of course, magnesium also. Best examples are sodium and potassium oxides which are soluble in water. Name 2 metal oxides which are soluble in water. Means it, potassium oxide and sodium oxide are soluble in water. They are actually metal. Metallic oxides are bases. Metallic oxides are bases. Bases which are soluble in water are called?
Alkalis.
Very good. Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. Children, normally metallic oxides are bases. Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. All alkalis are bases only, but all bases are not alkalis. All alkalis are bases only, but all bases are not alkalis because they should be soluble in water. They should be soluble in water. Next question, children. Please see here. Next question. With the help of equation, show that Al2O3 is an amphoteric oxide. Can anyone tell what is meant by amphoteric, children? Can anyone say what is meant by amphoteric, children? Amphoteric oxide. What do you mean by amphoteric oxide? Amphoteric oxide, anyone? Vedant, what do you mean by amphoteric oxide?
Sir, it is both acidic and basic regard to which...
Actually, it is base, no?
Yes, sir. Acid is base, but it can be an acid in some conditions.
Actually, it is a base. It should react with acids. Okay? But amphoteric oxides are those which can react with both acids and bases.
Oh.
There are two examples of amphoteric oxides, zinc oxide and aluminium oxide. What are amphoteric oxides which can react with both acids and bases? Amphoteric, ampho means two lives are there, amphibians like that. Amphoteric oxides react with both acids and bases. Amphoteric oxides react with both acids and bases. Amphoteric oxides react with both acids and bases. Best example is aluminium oxide. Aluminium oxide can react with HCl and aluminium oxide can react with the NaOH also. If you want, I will write the reaction and also I will show you. Here you will get aluminium chloride and water, and here you will get the NaAlO2 plus H2O. Amphoteric oxides are those oxides which can react with both acids and bases. Amphoteric oxides are those oxides which can react with both acids and bases. Next one. Write an equation for the reaction of zinc with sodium carbonate. Zinc with sodium bicarbonate. Zinc with NaOH. So children, if ever you remember, children, so metal plus, is asking like this. Any acid, let us take one acid. Which acid you want, children? Tell me which acid you want.
Hydrochloric acid.
Okay. He is telling to show the reaction of HCl with zinc. HCl with NaOH, he's asking. HCl with Na2CO3 is asking, and HCl with NaHCO3 is asking, children. So, if ever you remember the properties of acids, acids with metal forms?
Salt plus hydrogen gas.
Acid with base forms?
Salt plus hydrogen.
Water. Acid plus carbonate forms?
Salts plus water.
Plus carbon. Acid plus bicarbonate forms? salt plus water plus carbon dioxide. Please, children, remember, children, this one. Acid with metal, salt plus hydrogen. Acid with base, salt plus water. Acid with carbonate, salt plus water plus carbon dioxide. Acid with bicarbonate, salt plus water plus carbon dioxide. If you remember only, it will be useful, children. Even in 10th class, like these questions will come. So ZnCl2 plus H2 gas you will get because salt plus hydrogen. Acid with base, salt plus water. Okay, so NaCl plus H2O. Acid with bicarbonate, salt plus water plus carbon dioxide. Acid bicarbonate, salt plus water plus carbon dioxide gas. Salt plus water plus carbon dioxide gas. Okay, children. Why there is no evolution of hydrogen when nitric oxide reacts with metals? Children, can anyone say this one? Children, nitric acid with any metal do not liberate hydrogen gas. Why? This is a question. Because nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent. Nandika, are you listening, children? Nandika, are you listening? Nandika, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
From where you bought these questions? All 10th class questions, these are. Anyway, no problem. Listen, children, metal plus acid, any metal plus acid should give salt plus hydrogen gas. Any metal plus acid should leave salt plus hydrogen gas. Metal plus acid should give salt plus hydrogen gas, but nitric acid do not liberate hydrogen gas. Why? Because nitric acid is the strongest oxidizing agent. Instead of liberating hydrogen, it will liberate water. Instead of liberating nitrogen dioxide, it will liberate nitrous oxide. Okay, like that. So why nitric acid do not liberate hydrogen gas? Because it is a strong oxidizing agent. All acids will liberate hydrogen, yes, but nitric acid won't liberate because nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent. Nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent, which does not liberate hydrogen. Nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent which does not liberate hydrogen. Nitric acid do not liberate hydrogen from any acid. Nitric acid do not liberate hydrogen with any metal except magnesium and manganese. Only magnesium and manganese has capacity to liberate hydrogen. Okay, children, nitric acid do not liberate hydrogen with any metal except magnesium and manganese. What is reactivity series of metals? Children, what is reactivity series of metals? Arrangement of metals in decreasing sodium, order of reactivity.
Sodium, potassium, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, calcium,
aluminium, zinc,
iron, phosphorus, lead, hydrogen, copper, and mercury.
Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity. What is reactivity series? Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity. What is reactivity series, children? Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of their reactivity. Potassium is the highest and silver is the least. Of course, gold, platinum, still so many are there, I'm telling. What is reactivity series? Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity. Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity. Okay, can anyone tell again? Surya, can you tell what is the definition of reactivity series? Surya?
Metals in reactivity.
Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity. Again, you say, Surya, arrangement of metals in?
Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity.
Nandika, can you say what is a reactivity series? Nandika?
Yes, sir.
What is a reactivity series? Is what? Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity.
Sir.
Arrangement of metals in decreasing order of reactivity.
Reactivity.
Okay. What you are saying, I am only saying. What is electrovalent bond? Show the formation of ionic bond.
Sir? Sir, even tin is also there, no, sir?
Yes, ma'am, it is there. It is there. After I mean, yes, it is there. So, children, next. What is electrovalent bond they are asking? Do you know what is ionic bond, children? I didn't say ionic bond for you any time, children, because it is not needed for you. I didn't say she bought all this. Nana? Okay, next question. Surya, can you tell one question? Why gold and silver are present in free state? Next question. Why gold and silver are present in free state? Surya, can you say why gold and silver are present in free state?
Because they have very less reactivity.
Very good, fantastic. Because they are very less reactive. They are present at the bottom. They are very less reactive. They are very less reactive. So they do not corrode. When they do not corrode, you'll get in free state. Free state is not free of cost. Free state is they do not react with the metals. As it is metals, you will get. Next, sodium is never found in free state. Can anyone say why? Suju, are you there? Sujit?
Yes,
Suju?
Sir.
Why sodium is never found in free state? Why sodium is never found in free state? Because it is?
Highly reactive.
It is never found in free state. The sulfide one is converted into oxides. When you refine electrolytically, when you refine any element electrolytically, what are the conditions, Raghuram?
Yes.
What should be cathode, what should be anode, and what should be electrolyte? When you refine any elements electrolytically.
So the electrolysis will.
But when you want to refine, purify any metal electrolytically, what are the three conditions? What is cathode, what is anode, what is electrolyte? I told you this.
Yes, so salt of anode should be the electrolyte.
Means the element which we want to purify, impure metal should be anode.
Impure metal should be anode, and the pure metal to provide coating should be cathode.
No, and electrolyte should be salt of the metal to be purified.
Metal to be purified.
I'm not asking coating, only refining. If you want to purify copper, impure copper, you should take it as
anode.
Already existing pure copper, you should take it as cathode. And electrolyte should be salt of copper, like that. If you want to purify iron, impure iron, you should take it as anode. Pure iron, you should take it as cathode. And salt of iron should be taken as
electrolyte,
like that, children. So impure metal is anode, cathode should be pure metal, and electrolyte should be salt of the metal to be purified. Okay. Children, how is steel different from stainless steel? Anyone? Pravalika, how is steel different from stainless steel? Pravalika? Vedant? Steel corrode. Stainless steel?
Does not corrode.
Do not corrode. And what is the composition of steel?
Iron plus carbon.
Stainless steel is?
Iron plus carbon plus chromium.
Chromium and nickel. Iron plus carbon plus chromium plus nickel. Stainless steel do not corrode. Can anyone tell what is the definition of alloy?
A homogeneous mixture of two metals.
Two or more metals. Metal and non-metal. Alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals and a non-metal. Some of the examples, brass. What is brass, children? What is that? Brass is an alloy of copper and zinc. And bronze. Bronze is an alloy of
copper plus tin.
Copper and tin. Okay. Solder is an alloy of solder. Lead and tin. Steel is an alloy of iron plus carbon. Iron is a metal, carbon is a non-metal. Iron is a metal, carbon is a non-metal. Alloy can be a mixture of metal and non-metal also, no problem. Alloy can be a mixture of metal and non-metal also. Okay, children, so these are some of the differences. I didn't say ionic bonding because I never taught you ionic bonding, but these are, okay, children, these are the questions we discussed in metals and non-metals. I will be sending the questions for your reference also. If you want, you can practice them.